a lot of the meets with me. She supports me a lot behind the scenes. She's one of our biggest fans, so thanks for coming to a lot of stuff to me.
Yeah!
I'd like to acknowledge our incredible captains this year, Sarah Anderson, Cameron Bowman, Renee Sanford, Joey Ann, and Thomas LeClaire. You guys did an incredible job, and you will be sorely missed. So thanks for all you did this year. Woohoo! I'd like to thank all the parents in attendance. Obviously, without the parents this season and this evening would not be possible. Our booster parents worked so hard and so much for a lot of thankless, just for thankless hours behind the scenes, the many fundraisers they do throughout the season. And also, I want to thank the parents for always opening your homes for the pasta dinners. That's the kids. You'll see later on when I'm talking about what the seniors' favorite things are throughout the season. That is on the top of all of their lists. So thank you for opening your homes for them and doing pasta dinners throughout the season. I really appreciate that as well. Annual tradition, I'd like all the athletes to stand up, take a few moments, thank your parents, applaud them, all they do. We are not here without them. So please do that.
Yeah. Yeah. Woohoo!
Give them a hug when you get home, too. Please.
Yep.
We have an incredible group of booster parents, so and we have some leaving us this year, so if you are new and you're shy, that's okay. But I know that booster parents would love some more support, and to jump on board and help us out with anything that you can help us with, whatever time you can, it would be great. That being said, we had our 7th annual zombie road race this past Saturday. It was a huge success, as evidenced by how many people we had there. It was 200 plus. We were competing against 12 other road races on Saturday morning locally, so it is incredible what we pulled off. So on that note, I'd like to take a minute to recognize a group of parents who have been with us for a while now and are a huge part of the success of the road race. They work tirelessly and donate a ton of time and energy. They get nothing in return. They only get to see the program enhanced and things given back to you athletes. So in that respect, they're role models for us all. So the boosters, the coaches, and athletes would like to recognize these parents, and some of whom will be moving on after this season. So we'd like to bring up front Pam Anderson, Beth Annan, Leanne LeClaire, and of course, Denise Sanford.
Yeah.
I can't even tell you how much these parents do behind the scenes. All right, let's get on to the season highlights. The girls had a tough regular season this year as they moved into the TVL large division. Medway moved down and we moved up. They ended the season at 1-5, competed against some of the highest ranking teams in the state, including Westwood and Hopkinton. They finished 6th overall at the TVL championship. And a big highlight from that meet was our own Katie Bradley was the TVL champion this year, beating out some tough Congrats to you, Katie. If you were there, you saw one heck of a race. It was really fun to watch. You have the pace per mile charts on your tables. We have not competed in the state coaches or the state championship or all states at this point, so stay tuned. We will be sending emails and posting on the blog. On the boys' side, in dual meets, the boys' team has had an overall record of 27 wins and 2 losses in the last 4 years. Coming off of 2 straight TVL conference team titles, our boys made another run at it this year. Came up a little short, but the boys came in 3rd out of 10 teams at the TVL championship. Their regular season record was 4-2, very commendable. Senior captain Joey Annan was also the TBL champion this year at the TBL Championship. And he was voted at the coaches meeting a couple of nights ago, the Tri-Valley League MVP. So as I said with the girls, stay tuned for results from our invite this coming Saturday and then the MIAA Division 5 meet in a couple of weeks and hopefully all states. So unfortunately, at that part of the night where we are going to talk about some seniors, we're losing some seniors this year. I asked them to say a few things about themselves, what they will miss most about cross country, and they took it among themselves to write down their favorite quotes of things that I say. So it's going to be a little awkward me saying them because I say them, and I'm reading about what you said about yourself. You'll see, it's going to be weird. All right. So senior captain Cameron Bowman, I'm going to start with, it's her birthday, so why not, right? Cambo plans on attending college next fall and will be majoring in nursing. What she will miss most is being part of such a close-knit team and eating pounds of pasta with her teammates each week. Her favorite memory takes place on the day they did the overpass workout. After finishing the last interval, Katie, Sarah, and her were doing the Riggy Shuffle back to the high school. If you don't know what the Riggy Shuffle is, it's when you're really, really exhausted, and I still don't let you walk, so you gotta shuffle, so it kind of seems like you're still running. So it's not running and it's not walking, it's like this.
That's the
rig. So it does keep your heart rate up a little bit. Alright, so the riggy shuffle turned into a walk, which I would have allowed if I'd seen, and then it just gets worse from here. The riggy shuffle turned into a walk due to how tired they were from the workout. The boys, who were once a few feet ahead, were now totally out of sight. With over 2 miles to go, us girls were dreading on how long it would take them to get back to the high school, and they started yelling, "Please give us a ride," at the cars that passed by. Now, I do not advocate this in any way, by the way. This is not a good practice. Well, one car heard them and stopped. Now, at this point, when I was reading this email, I said, I'm going to get arrested. First of all, I'm going to lose my job as a coach. And then I'm going to get arrested. Bear with me for a second. So one car heard them and stopped. The driver said that they would drop them off wherever they wanted. So obviously they got in the car. Obviously, right? You're right. Yeah. They told the driver to drop them off in Wheaton. They were about to get out, when they saw the boys running by. So they got out of the car and sprinted behind a building to hide until the boys ran by. Did you guys even know this happened?
Yeah, me too.
Once the coast was clear, they started back up to the high school. Cameron would like to give a shout out to the kind driver. She says that person is sitting among us in the room tonight. You know who you are, and I'm trying to train these kids, you know? I'm trying to get them better. That's all I'm saying. You're all right. She's a nice lady. Cambo says her favorite Coach Taylor quote is, "Did you know that facetious is the only word in the English dictionary that has all the vowels in order in it?" I say that all the time. I really do. Senior Captain Renee Sanford. Renee hopes to attend either the University of Rhode Island for textile marketing or the University of Connecticut for materials engineering next year. She will miss the team pasta dinners and the bus rides the most, but running up the Medfield Mountain at TBLs is a close second. I'm pretty sure she's being facetious. The most memorable moment out of the past 4 seasons for her is from her freshman year when they were on their way back from the overpass. See, I read your email after her, and I just couldn't believe it. I said, I hope you didn't get picked up by a car, too. You were on your way back from the overpass, and the group she was with stopped and was walking outside of Wheaton, when all of a sudden the varsity boys came running behind them and we heard the coach yelling, "There's no walking in cross country," and threatening to make them do 800s on the track if they didn't get back before the boys. They all started sprinting, and she thinks that's still the fastest she's ever run in her life. On to senior captain Joey Annan. Joey doesn't know where he's going to go to college yet, but wherever he goes, he plans on majoring in chemistry or chemical engineering. What he will miss most is listening to George Michael on the car rides to preview the other school's courses. Thomas's obscure statements in the captain's circle, doing hybrid workouts, he still doesn't know what they are and doesn't want to know. The missing practice in missing practice to study for AP chemistry. His favorite memory is when his sophomore year at the Twilight meet, Mike Tierney gave him 5-hour energy before the race, and throughout the whole race he never stopped talking to Mike and Chris. During the race, like when you were running, you were still talking? Following the meet, when the team stopped at McDonald's on the way home, Coach Stalters noticed that his hands were shaking uncontrollably. He has not taken a 5-hour energy since then. Joey's favorite Coach Taylor quotes are, "That's malarkey," and in the Chris Wren voice,
"Coach, what's my split?"
Yeah.
Senior Captain Thomas DeClaire will be attending college next year. He has applied to Fordham University, Loyola University, Maryland, Fairfield University, UMaine, Orono, URI, Marist College, and Quinnipiac University. God bless your parents. He plans to major in communications and hopes to continue running in college. He will miss most. What he will miss most about cross country is being part of such a hard-working team, the pasta dinners.
No, Mike.
We lost your mic.
Check. Hello.
I think it was a Chris Wren voice.
Yeah.
Check. No.
Stop loading. You can do it.
Yeah, testing 1, 2, 3. Ha!
Extended time roll.
Technical difficulties? Please stand by.
College. Can everybody hear me?
Yeah.
I'm jumping like this. All right. What he will miss most about cross country is being part of such a hard-working team, the pasta dinners, the excitement felt at the start at the start line before each race, and pretty much everything about cross country. He has a lot of great memories from XC that will last a lifetime, but his all-time favorite would have to be when, against all odds, the Norton boys team was able to win the TBL championship meet for the first time ever in the pouring rain. One of my favorites. He also passed like 300 runners in the last season. The number goes up, it's like a fish story, but it's true. His favorite Coach Taylor quote is, "That's money in the bank." He'd like to thank myself and Coach Bradley for all their hard work and for always being there for us. Well, thank you for being there for us too, Thomas. Senior Captain Sarah Anderson. Sarah does not know what college she will be going to next year at this point, but plans on majoring in speech-language pathology. She will miss the pre-meet scouting reports and the people on the team the most. Her favorite XC memory is the time we were on the bus coming home from a meet and peanut butter squares were being passed around. It wasn't funny. When I found out, she stood up to check to make sure that nobody was allergic. Nobody on the team responded, but a minute later the bus driver quietly said, "I am." And then I shouted, "Shut it down, shut it down." The bus got really quiet because most of the team were already eating the peanut butter.
Her favorite Coach Taylor quote is, "This one's going to be a barn burner, guys." Senior Chris Tatarczyk. Chris will be majoring in education. He applied to UMass Boston, Salem State, and Lesley University. He says that what he will miss most about Norton Cross Country is Matt Anderson. His favorite memory from Norton Cross Country is the Wheaton Hill workouts with the bros. What's a Wheaton Hill workout?
When you run a week and you roll down the hill, and you try to run afterwards.
Is that
true, Brian?
I never did it. Senior Andre Nguyen. In case you don't know, Andre came to us from Vietnam. He was with us for this season. We were lucky to have him. It's been a pleasure to have you on the team. Andre hopes to go to UMass Boston next year and major in psychology. He will miss the team atmosphere. He says everyone is supportive and tries their best to get better. His favorite memory is the hill workout. I don't know what hill workout is. He thinks it's important to improve himself both physically and mentally. He says it is better to keep going than stop. I would say that's a life lesson. So, even though, this is me saying this. I text this after. I wrote Andre. Even though I didn't know where you were half the time this year, so I wrote you didn't do a favorite quote. So I just wrote my favorite quote from the season was "Where's Andre?" We enjoyed having you. Senior Joey Cronin. Yep. Senior Joey Cronin. Joey's applying to Sacred Heart University, Hofstra University, Emerson College, and URI for a double major in Theater Performing Arts and English. He plans on running in college, but is debating on whether or not he will run competitively. He will miss trying to start sing-alongs during distance runs, going out for post-run squad-ups with the lads. What's a squad-up?
Squad-up? Don't worry about it.
A lot of the time, parents, I just don't ask. Giving top-notch motivational speeches to Austin, Alex, and Sean, and getting some professional dating advice from the girls' team. Thank you for that. But he's mostly going to miss looking forward to practice after tough days at school, knowing that at the end of the day, he would be running with the best team a guy could ask for. This team has become almost like a family to him these past 3 years, and he would not give it up for anything else in the world. His two favorite memories from cross country would have to be when he finished his race at DS this year, thinking that he lost the meet for the team, when we actually ended up beating them by 1 point.
Wow.
The other would have to be after the Medfield meet this year when Joey Annett and him walked past each other saying in perfect unison, "Good race today, Joey." His favorite Coach Taylor quote is, "Every point matters."
Yep.
Woo! It's true. It does, right? 26-27. Senior Evan Garone has applied to... Evan... has applied to Bridgewater State, Emerson College, Keene State, Fitchburg State, and UMass Amherst. He will be majoring in communications and focusing in film and media production. These last 4 years have been filled with so many fond memories, it's hard to pick just one, so he's going to list a few. First, First is the time that a certain athlete on this team who will remain nameless faked an injury in order to escape doing an overpass workout. I don't think they're that bad. To escape doing an overpass workout, but we ended up not doing the overpass that day anyway. Next is the time this same nameless athlete hurt their ankle and was worried they wouldn't be able to run in a race. So their solution was to take 5 Tylenol at once and wash them down with 5-hour energy.
No. Tell people about 5-hour energy. I don't think it's a good thing. I don't use it myself. It didn't end well. No kidding. Love Morrissey will never forget the time that this same athlete, hopefully this person discloses who they are at the end of this, that this same athlete showed up with a pair of sunglasses that they claimed to be a cheap pair that they had gotten as a present. Then the athlete proceeds to break the glasses in half and throw them away. A few minutes later, we found out that those sunglasses were $150 Oakleys and that there was no way to repair them. Needless to say, it was pretty funny. Mm-hmm. Before I go to the rest, can we name? Can we know who this is? It's you.
Rookie year.
You've learned a lot since then, right?
Yeah.
Oh well. Undoubtedly, the thing he will miss most about this team is all the awesome people that he's gotten to know over the years. He could go on and on. No kidding. About the good times they had together, but he won't because it would take all night. Too late. His favorite Coach Taylor quote, of course, was, "No ludicrous mid-race dabbing." Shouldn't be dabbing during the race. You! Now, I think this would be a good time to perhaps... give the boosters some gifts. I mean, sorry, not the boosters. give the seniors some gifts from the boosters. So the boosters are going to come up, Lee and LeClaire and company, and give some of the seniors some senior gifts.
Seniors a gift from boosters. Due to the fundraising that the team does, we're able to do these kinds of things. And I think what's most impressive is the fact that the fundraising that we do, the kids on the team do all the heavy lifting. They wash the cars, they go canning, and especially this year when we had to panic the day of the meet and we had to can and go to a meet, and it was kind of a lot to ask for the kids, but they did it. And then, of course, the zombie run. If we didn't have the race directors and we didn't have the team, we wouldn't have the race. And it is growing year by year, and it's really successful. So because of all the hard work that the team does, we're able to give back to them, and the boosters are really proud of that. So thank you to the athletes. And now we'd like to have the seniors come up and get their gifts, which aren't wraps, so you know what they are.
I'm finishing. I'm working on that plate.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. And Coach Bradley and Coach Taylor. Without the two of you, the race would be non-existent. We know that. So just a little thank you from the Booster Department. And now the seniors can come up and present their gifts to the coaches. Coach Bradley and Coach Taylor are the backbone of this cross country team. It's not facetious. So we got them a little something to show us, to show them how grateful us athletes are.
And on behalf of the team, we have a gift for Coach Bradley and Coach Taylor as well.
Should we open it? This one, yes? All right. I see Dale back there. Open it up. Look at this wrapping.
It's like my grandmother. I'll save the wrapping.
What could it be? What could it be? What is that? What is that? What is that? Ooh. Oh, wow! Oh my gosh! Holy cow!
That's awesome.
Thank you.
I love this. We all signed it back. That is awesome.
beautiful.
Eric Sanford. Thank you guys. That's so cool. Thank you so much. I love it.
You deserve it.
Good job, Tom. Good job, seniors. Good job, Joe.
I love that.
Beautiful.
That's
so
awesome. I don't understand what's happening. Are you the
Sanford? Hello. Alright, so, I'd just like to thank the seniors for being with us. We've known you guys for 3 years. And the boys kind of have a bad rap for senior gifts. Like, I know the moms don't like our senior gifts. we're not known for getting the most awesome gifts.
No, you're not.
And, hey, but this year, we made an effort to change that. And while they might not be, like, quilt knitted, each teammate making a patch or whatever. We just put some thought into this stuff, so we'd just like to give them out. Evan Garone. Open the card first.
Banquet, and that's spelled banquet.
What is that? They got the sunglasses back!
Wait,
hold on. Can you hold that up, Evan, real quick?
No way, these are the right ones. You did not waste $150 on these.
No, we wasted $5.
Because ladies love animals?
Oh, yeah.
How did I ever get a date anyway?
Yo, Wheeler, call them all up.
Alright, wait. Oh, yeah.
Andre.
What
else
is that?
Andre.
Is that...
Yo, this is literally Christmas.
Okay. Chris Tatarzik.
Oh, dude.
No way.
Yeah. Yeah. That's an infant size.
Yeah, Chris.
It's a large infant. Like,
yeah. Get the joke? Large infant, yeah.
Yeah.
Thomas McClain. And Joanne.
Yeah, Tom! Yeah, Joe!
Thanks, Peter.
Is this some kind of like water balloon or
whatever? It's one of those punching things.
Oh, yeah!
Oh, man, I need this.
You need those?
Yeah!
Wait, and they're minion themed.
Are they minion themed?
They're minion
themed. Oh my god, they're minion themed. I want to pinch minions so bad. Punch minions so bad.
Ha ha ha!
You know me.
That's a real thought.
Oh my god.
You know me.
Now, what are these?
Yeah, Barack Obama with a three-peat.
He's in the picture because he's not the president, but he's
yo, wait, we got coal? What do you mean we got coal? Man, we went out of here!
Wait, is it the gum coal?
Oh my god.
Wish.
It's the flag.
That's gum. Man, you spent money on straight up coal.
It says you
love you, Wheeler.
I know. That these other guys.
I did this for 3 years just to see that. Worth it.
All right, now moving on. Wow.
Oh, no, it's
did you say that these gifts were going to be better than the gifts in the past?
Yeah, because Cronin got the Oakleys. Evan got some movies magnets because he loves movies.
Wait,
well, Thomas got a free
movie. Alright, ladies, you're up.
He's made up of Thomas.
They have a heart.
Compared to the mirror,
he has a heart.
Yeah, I mean. Wow, this is a good banquet! Yes!
Andre, yeah. Andre, sure, it might have been.
Seven great leaders for all of us to look up to. We are truly going to miss each of you, so come on up and grab your gifts, and good luck wherever your futures bring you.
Did they get minion punching balloons too?
Yeah, did you? I'm sorry. I saw my card.
Oh, look at the picture! Oh, it's so adorable! Oh, Sarah Renee! Oh, adorable in the pic, Cameron, Renee, and Sarah. You all look adorable! Oh, everybody! Oh. Who would like to make the little company in the banquet?
Oh,
Whoa. It says soul sister.
Oh, soul sister.
Soul like a like shoe.
Ah, soul sister. Oh. Mm-hmm.
Let the record show that there are personalized cards from everybody.
Wow. Thank you. Thank you.
And if you're a captain, you can grab an XC pin and a captain pin as well. All right. On the girls' side, varsity letter winners on the year were Katie Bradley, Cameron Bowman, Sarah Anderson, Renee Sanford, Hannah DeLay, Callie Shea, Kaylee Annan, Abby Obi, and Catherine Whittington. Boys' side, Joey Annan, Austin Carroll, Thomas LeClaire, DJ Nihil, Francis Cronin, James Wilson, Zach Steele, Krista Tarzik, Evan Garone, Alex Wisnaskis, Ryan Wheeler, Ryan LaFrancis, and Ethan Tatro. It's the most varsity letters I've given out since I've taken over, I'll tell you that. We had a lot of movement on the back end, but that's not a bad thing. To the TBL All-Stars, please come up and receive your certificate. On the girls' side, TBL All-Star first teamer, Katie Bradley. In TBL honorable mentions on the girls' side, Cameron Bowman and Sarah Anderson.
Yeah.
On the boys' side, TBL All-Star first teamer and the league's most valuable runner, Joey Annand. TBL All-Star first teamer, Austin Carroll. TBL honorable mentions Thomas LeClaire and DJ Nihil. Our ultimate teammate awards. This encompasses teamwork, positive energy, determination, and having a great attitude all the time. On the girls' side, our ultimate teammate is Callie Shea. I'll tell you, with Callie, she had an injury early in the season, and she battled, and she fought, and she came to all the meets, she came to all the practices. She always was positive, cheering for her teammates, and that's pretty much why you got it, because you're just a positive person all around. Even when you were injured, it was great. On the boys' side, our ultimate teammate is Evan Garone.
Yeah, Evan!
Our rookies of the year. These rookie newcomers These rookie newcomers to the team made the most strides, helped the team, represented themselves in the school to the best of their ability. We have two rookie of the years on the girls' side. Our first rookie of the year was Hannah DeLay. Our second rookie of the year was freshman Kaylee Annan.
Katie.
And our boys' rookie of the year was freshman Ethan Tatro.
Yay, Ben!
The following awards will receive plaques from the school. However, they're not made yet, as our banquet's fairly early this year. So when I do receive them from the AD, these athletes will get those plaques. We're going to start with the most improved. On the girls' side, this athlete went from our 7th/8th ranked athlete last year to our consistent number 4 varsity athlete this year. She went from 46 plus varsity points last year to 30 this year. Remember, less is more at XC. She stepped up as a leader of this team, being a captain, and handled the position with grace and ease. She made incredible improvements over her 4 years as an athlete on this team, starting her freshman year time trial, and I know she doesn't want me to say it, but I'm going to say it anyway. She started her freshman year time trial with a 9:44 pace, in sporting a 7:29 per mile pace this year. For all these reasons and more, senior captain Renee Sanford is our next.
Yeah, Renee!
On the boys' side, this athlete easily deserves this award. He has come a long way in 4 years. Heck, he's come a long way in 1 year. This athlete worked really hard over the summer and the season to become the athlete he is today. He fought back through an early season injury to get himself into the Dover-Sherborne meet and valiantly placed 5th overall to secure a 26-27 one-point victory. Even the DS coach said to me after the meet, "Where the heck did your number 5 runner come from?" This athlete started his XC journey sophomore year with us. Yeah, get yourself together here. This athlete started his XC journey sophomore year with us with a 9:08 pace in his time trial and has worked his way down to a 5:57 per mile pace for 5K this year. Our most improved athlete is easily Joey Cronin. Our MVP. On the girls' side, she plays first in every meet of the season for our girls. She's easily the girls' most valuable runner. She's a Taunton Daily Gazette All-Scholastic, a Sun Chronicle first-team All-Star. She's a TVL first-team All-Star. Her best pace per mile on the year so far is a 6:06, and she sported a 19-flat 5K. She currently holds the Norton High School 5K school record. She has a great attitude, always tries her best, always cheers on her teammates, and is one of the easiest athletes a coach could ever work with. For these reasons and more, Katie Bradley is our MVP. Our MVP on the boys' side, this senior athlete placed first for the boys in every single meet of the season. He went undefeated on the season. His best per mile pace on the year is 5:12. He's a Taunton Daily Gazette All-Scholastic, a Sun Chronicle first-team All-Star. He's voted by the coaches in the league as a TVL All-Star first-teamer, and it was a unanimous vote by the league coaches to be the Tri-Valley League MVP. He currently holds our current 5K school record. He's had a phenomenal season. We're looking forward to seeing what he does in the postseason. He's a great captain, and this is why Joey Annan is our MVP. Our JFK Award goes to the student athlete who best represents themselves, the team, and Norton High School athletics. These athletes will be missed greatly. They're great leaders and even better people. We have a lot to learn from them. They're great student athletes and they're great role models. The JFK Award winners for the fall 2016 cross country season are Sarah Anderson and Cameron Bowman. And for the boys, the JFK Award winner is Thomas LeClaire. program, leadership qualities, rapport with fellow athletes, have received positive input from their teachers and current captains, have received input from the current team, have participated in cross country for numerous seasons, and have submitted a letter of intent and are dedicated to the program and its ideals. I appreciate all the applications, per usual, to be captain of this team. These decisions are never easy. That being said, the girls' captains for the 2017 season are Katie Bradley, Callie Shea, and Abby O'Brien.
Yeah, Katie, Callie, and Abby!
And our boys' captains will be Ryan Wheeler and Alex Wisnaskis.
Ryan and Alex!
Congrats to you all. Coach Bradley and myself are looking forward to working with you. On a quick housekeeping note, if you could please return your uniforms to me as soon as possible next week. If you're not moving on to states, it would expedite the process a lot. If you are doing indoor track, you're going to get a different uniform for indoor track. So please know that. So we're going to finish the evening with a presentation put together.